In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our brothers and sisters, as we come together to worship the Lord, let us prepare our hearts so that we might enter into these mysteries of the Lord's death and resurrection with an open heart.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Thank you. in the flesh. He offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverence. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
in Bergen County, and at least once a year I would take the bus and subway over to the Metropolitan Museum of Natural Art. A beautiful museum that's huge, probably one of the best in the world. But one time I was walking down one of the galleries, and there was a teacher with a group there before a Picasso. And he's rather abstract and art. I wanted to move on, but I decided, let me just listen. And it was fascinating. She kind of took the whole painting apart and then put it back together. And when she finished, I could hear the music, you know, the beauty. And I was so grateful that I didn't move on, because I was, you know, Picasso was able to communicate to us his life. And when we come together, you know, each week, we listen to the Word of God. The Scriptures are the living Word of God. It's not the newspaper. There's a certain power there that needs to be listened to and worked on. And just like with great art, we need to take it apart. We need somebody, and then we need the Holy Spirit bring us into the mystery of what God wants to tell us. And I came to see the wisdom of the liturgy, because every year we go over the same thing, you know, the life of Jesus and his birth. We have Lent, Easter, and so we want to enter into the mystery of the process. And we see in the Gospel there were some Greeks. I don't know whether they were pagans or could have been Christians that lived in Greece. They wanted to meet Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ was starting to really get attention. The miracles and the healings that he was performing, the power. And anybody who's been watching The Chosen can see that. And they wanted to come to know Jesus, and he didn't give a catechism answer to it. I mean, he gave us something that he said, the hour has not come. Now the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. And this is something we hear. My hour hasn't come, and now it has come. And he's talking about his death. And he used an analogy. I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. Many of you might have seeds in your kitchen ready to plant once time is right. Those seeds have to die if there's going to be life. And all of us need to die if we're going to have life. And there's two kinds of life. One is dying to ourselves. He tells us again and again, unless you die, you won't have life. And if you hold on to your life, you're not going to have life. C.S. Lewis compares it to an egg. If an egg isn't broken, it's going to go bad. But there's no choice. And so helping us go into the mystery of our lives, that we need to die. We need not to hold on to it. We need to constantly, when we get something, give it away as a gift. If we hold on, we're going to die. And there is a joy in giving. And so he's ready to move into death. And all of us says, I am troubled now. Jesus was troubled. Even in the garden, he said, Lord, I'd rather have this cross pass me by, whatever your will is. And he said, yeah, what should I say? The Father, save me from this hour. But it was for this purpose that I came to this hour. So his whole purpose of his life was to save us, and he was going to do it through the cross. And later on it says, now is the time of judgment on the world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. Who's the ruler of this world? Satan. Why? They had the same problem then as we have now. There will be this, and then I will be lifted up, and I will draw everyone to myself. So the Lord gives us a plan. And the Word of God is a living Word, and it has to be alive for our lives. This is our time. And so what is this scripture telling us? This is our time of judgment on the world. Now the rulers of this world will be driven out. That's Satan.
Do you think there are a lot of rulers?
Is Satan having a good time in our world today? I remember when I was in high school, we used to pray for the conversion of Russia. Those who are old enough, you know, might remember that part of the message of Fatima. For world peace, to have peace in the world. And she wanted peace, she said, was to turn back to God, do penance, pray a rosary, and if not, then Russia would spread their atheistic ideology. Not the exact words, but their errors. And haven't we seen that now? It is filtered in every part of our culture. Into our schools, into our entertainment, into the church that is getting more and more divided. And so, in essence, so we see that this is our time. We have to face it with faith and courage. And so the Word of God can help us. And the Lord will make His plan. Cardinal Burke, looking at the world situation, has invited those who want, to make a 9-month novena to Mary, to Our Lady of Chester Hope, Our Lady of Guadalupe. And he said he looked at it, he said, back in the 1500s, the world was very similar to what's going on now. The Ottoman Empire was about to take over the world. There was a battle in which they far outnumbered us in numbers and votes, as it was then. And so the Holy Father called on us for the intercession of Mary. And those of you know the story is, at the last moment, the winds shifted, and the Christian world won the battle. Again, he points out, he has a little video which is going talking about that, and then talks about Our Lady of Guadalupe, the Aztec Indians worship the pagan gods, to placate God, they offered up their sons in waters, in fires. A lot of the Franciscan missionaries and Jesuits tried to work with them and weren't successful. But in the with Saint Santiago, she worked that miracle with the Talma, which carrying he was always trying to let her run away from Mary, and he said the bishop, Mary wanted to build a church on that spot. So he saw it was in the winter, there were roses, and put the roses in the Talma and had it there. And then, as he went to drop the roses before the bishop, there was the image of Our Lady of Guadalupe, made out of kind of cactus material, which doesn't last very long. It's been over 500 years. Scientists can't figure it out. It's not like what the material is, and what it's not paint. So that miracle. But the real miracle was within 9 years, 10 million of the Aztecs converted to Christianity. And so he's encouraging us to do that. Anybody's interested, Cardinal Burke, easy name to remember, the 9 months will be in, and we can take a look at it. But whatever we do, Lord, this is our hour to move in faith. You know, to convert, to use this time now. On Monday we have confessions, and in the morning to the afternoon again at night. If you have any confession a long time, if you need to go, convert. Reconciliation within the family. The ideology of atheism has brought devastation on the family on so many levels. That would be pointed out. And so the Lord calls on us to be people, of faith. To let the Word of God take root in our lives. It gives us strength so that we don't live in unnecessary fear. We need to trust in the Lord, not in the ideologies, not in the plans of the world, the politics, but to trust in the Lord. He tells us that I will lift you up from the earth, and I will draw everyone to myself, says the Lord.
I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Entrusting ourselves to the life-giving power of God, we voice our prayers to the Father.
For the Church, that she may enter more deeply into God's covenant of love and life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for those preparing to be received into the church this Easter, that they may always keep close to the Lord, we pray to the Lord. That those in civil governance may dedicate themselves to justice, peace, freedom, and a generous defense of the poor, we pray to the Lord. That our local community may benefit from the fruits of the national Eucharistic revival by spending more time adoring our Eucharistic Lord, we pray to the Lord. That our participation in the annual Catholic Appeal puts us in solidarity with those who suffer need of any kind on any day, especially those to whom the Lord has promised comfort, mercy, gentleness, and peace in the kingdom of heaven, we pray to the Lord. That God will cleanse the world of all errors, banish disease, comfort those who mourn, health to the sick, and salvation to the dying, we pray to the Lord. For those seeking joy, that they might witness the joy of faithful believers living in God's covenant of salvation in Jesus, we pray to the Lord. And for all who have died, whose names and faces we now recall. Especially today we remember Tina O'Donnell and Reverend Daniel Gower. May they and all of our loved ones rest from their labors, we pray to the Lord. And for our special intentions, which we now mention for the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Most merciful Father, forgive our evil doing and remember our sin no more. Prepare our hearts for the passion, death, and resurrection of your Son, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
As we prepare the table, please join in singing number 705, Yes, I Shall Rise, number 705.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful awaits the sacred Paschal feast with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the faithfulness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Do this in memory of me.
from Lydia. The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that You should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Just a few announcements before we leave. There'll be drop-in confessions in the main church this Monday from 11 a.m. till 1 p.m. and also from 6 to 8 in the evening. Also, the Altar Rosary Society is sponsoring a Women's Lent Retreat this Thursday in the Parish Center from 8:30 to 3. See today's bulletin for more information to register. Also, next Friday, the 22nd, children ages 5 to 10 are invited to the Excellent Adventure in the Parish Center. It's from 6 to 7. It's a free celebration with Easter crafts, stories, and activities. And also, we're still collecting items for the Blessing Bag Brigade. You'll see some of the needed items that are in the bulletin. Donations can be made until March the 26th. And lastly, the St. Vincent de Paul volunteers should be in the back handing out flyers telling you what lists of items they need to restock the pantry. Bow your heads for the blessing.
Bless, O Lord, your people who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what your prompting they desire, they may receive by your generous gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.